This is the third part in my tutorial for converting a board game to the touch table using Unity. In this part, I'm going to set up the main menu to allow players to join the game and select a color. Links to part 1 and 2, more detail about part 3, and the assets needed for this project are below. Even if you haven't read the accompanying blog for the prior two videos, this video will make a lot more sense with the background and reasoning provided in the blog post. I'm going to start by adding more behaviors to the controller object. I'm going to add the timeline, which will execute the events that drive the game flow, the game, which holds the model of the game, player list, which keeps track of the players, turn order, and table position, main menu, which controls the UI for the main menu, and game GUI, which controls the UI for the game. Let's start by populating the game GUI members. The game canvas and animation canvas are the canvases that we have already created. We can also drag in the ribbon sprites by locking the inspector view, then selecting all the ribbons and dragging them in. The load overlay is a screen that hides the main GUI while the game is initializing. We can create one by unlocking the inspector, then adding an image to the dialog canvas that is a solid black color and fills the screen. If initialization is slow, we can put some text onto that image to tell the players to wait. Drag that new load overlay into the game GUI. Next, I'll create UI elements for the main menu. First, I'll add a background image with the felt sprite. Create an image as a child of the main menu canvas. Set the sprite, and then set it to fill the canvas. Next, I'll make a title. This will be a text mesh UI element. Set the text to no thanks, and I'll make it yellow with a bit of a gradient. Make the text large and slightly above the center of the screen. Set it to be centered. We'll give the text an outline. To do that, we need to create a new material to hold the settings for the outlined text. If we change these settings without creating a new material, they will be applied to all text mesh objects. Turn on outlining and give it a thickness. We'll also increase the face dilation to make the text thicker. Next, I'll create four buttons. They will all use the rect button image in sliced mode with a transition of sprite swap using the gray version of the rect button for the disabled state. Replace the default text object with a text mesh object. This will be the start button, so set the text to start. Add an onclick callback and set the callback function to main menu on play button. Now I'll make three more buttons by copying the start button and changing the callback and the text. These buttons will be resume to load the last saved game, load to bring up the load canvas and display the saved games, and quit to exit the game. The next step is to make a login area for each player. This is a UI panel that the player will sit in front of. It will allow the player to join and leave the game and to pick their color. No Thanks plays 7, so there will be 7 of these login areas. They will be arranged around the table with 3 on the bottom, 3 on the top, and 1 on the left side. I'm using the border underscore 0 9 box sprite, colored gray, for the background. Add the behavior player login area. The panel will be split vertically with some instructions and the current player color on the top and a way to select colors on the bottom. Create an empty object, name it join area, and set it to fill the top. Create a text mesh object as a child of the join area. Set it to the left-hand side and set the text to tap to join game. Create another child that's an image. Move it to the right side and set the sprite to the chip. Add a button behavior to the join area. Set the transition to none and give it a callback of player login area on join clicked. Now create a new empty object filling the bottom of the login area. Name it color buttons and give it a horizontal layout behavior. Add an image to this area. Set the sprite to the chip and turn on preserve aspect. Copy this image 6 times and have the parent horizontal layout control the width and the height. Add a button behavior to all of these images. Set the transition to none and set the callback to player login area on color clicked. This function takes an integer parameter, which is the index of the color button. This is how the script knows which button was pressed. The player login script controls some of its UI objects. I'll tell it which child objects are which by setting its members. Drag in the controller for the main menu and chosen color and join text from the join area. Before I make copies of the login area for each player position, I will make the login area into a prefab so that if I need to make any changes to it, I can easily apply those changes to all of the other positions. Make a prefabs directory under assets, then drag the player login area into that prefabs directory. Place the first login area in the bottom right corner. Make a copy of it and move the copy to the bottom middle. Make another copy and move that to the bottom right. For the third copy, set the rotation Z to minus 90 and position it on the middle left. Finally, select the first 3 areas and press Ctrl D to copy all of them. With the new 3 selected, change the rotation Z to 180 and flip the sign of the Y position. Now, if you imagine the table lying flat, there are 7 login areas arranged to face the players. The last thing to do is set the position member of the player login area behavior so that the script knows which table position it belongs to. I'm almost ready to try out the main menu, but first I need to set up the members of the main menu behavior on the control object. Drag in the load canvas and the main menu canvas, the start and resume buttons. Then lock the inspector, select all the player login areas, and drag them in. Okay, let's run the game and see if it works. Sound seems to work, but I need to fix the scale so that I can see the whole screen in this window. Players can join and pick their color, However, the start button doesn't work. The start button isn't working because I need to tell the game how many players are needed to play. This will be our first code change. Bring up Visual Studio by double-clicking on the player list script. Set the static constants for min players to 3 and max players to 7. Switch back to Unity and try the main menu again. Add 3 players and the start button turns on. Clicking it starts the game, but all that does so far is hide the main menu and show the game canvas. In the next video, I'll create the UI for the game itself.